Getting certified is a really important part of your career path and development, but it's a bit of a jungle out there with some of these certification paths and figuring out which exam should I take, which one is right for me. So this video is your complete guide to what the exams are, which ones you should take, and how it all fits together so that you can get that right piece of paper. Virtual piece of paper, I guess now, that's right for where you're at in your career. Dynamics 365 is fundamentally two different types of product capability, broadly categorized as CRM and ERP. Now, feel free to cross the streams and do whichever exams work for you. Most people who work in this space specialize in one or the other. You might have a little bit of cross knowledge, but it's rare for anyone to be completely in depth across all of these. If you're one of those people, awesome. But generally speaking, you will either work on the CRM side of things, customer engagement applications like sales, marketing, customer service, field service, or within the ERP or finance and operations side, which covers those core accounting and finance processes, as well as supply chain management and some other applications in there around e-commerce, HR, and project operations. Now, regardless of which side you're on here, let me start by giving you some core principles about exam preparation and where to find the information, and then feel free to jump to the right timestamp for whichever piece of this is more interesting to you. So at the start, we have a fundamentals exam for each of these. The 910 exam is your CRM fundamentals, and your 920 exam is your ERP fundamentals. The fundamentals exams, I'm putting these together before I divide the content up here, are really suitable for anyone. These foundation level exams are not things that required deep technical hands-on knowledge. These are designed for people who are business users, business decision makers, those kinds of roles. So this is something where you're able to describe the capability of the platform rather than necessarily having actual hands-on experience. There are plenty of exams that I'm going to get to that really test that in-depth knowledge. So regardless of which way you go, this is a good way of getting the foundation across the entire platform if that's what you would like to have as a grounding. Let me take you through the learning resources and so on that go with these and that apply across all of the other ones as well. Every single exam has a page like this, and I'm just going to start with 910 because it's the first in the series. Incidentally, the 900 exams are the easiest. From there, the numbers do make a whole lot more sense. Essentially, they had already sort of put the exam numbers in place before they introduced these foundation level exams. So you'll find across anywhere in the Microsoft exam certification world that the ones that start with a 9, bizarrely, are actually the beginner foundation level exams. So what this does is takes you through a description of what the exam is. It takes you through some learning resources. So we've got the core skills measured, and then we've got ways to prepare. And every single exam in the series here will have a learning path on Microsoft Learn. That's your go-to. Those are free learning resources. They're not guaranteed to cover absolutely everything in the exam, but realistically speaking, especially at this foundation level, if you've done those Microsoft Learn paths, you should be in the zone to pass. There are also free practice assessments just at this foundation level for both the CRM and ERP side of it. So don't take exam dumps. Exam dumps are where people have illegally copied or memorized stuff from an exam and then reproduced it online. They are not reliable, they are not legal. This, however, is a good, legitimate way to practice, and I will come back at the end of the video with some other resources that are also legal. You can get legitimate practice tests if that's what you're after. So we have a multiple choice here. A company uses customer engagement apps. Employees use the My Open Leads view. They want to view this data graphically with drill down capability. You need to suggest something that requires more minimal effort. Let's see how I go here. I think that would be a chart. Let's check my answer. It'd be bad for my credibility at this point if I was getting that wrong. So you can see this is the type of question that you're getting at this foundational level here. A user wants to do this. What type of capability is in there? What pieces go with what? We're trying to solve a problem. What happens here? But you'll see there's 50 questions here. This is a CRM one. There's an equivalent for 910, which is the ERP for 50 questions. So this is a very good preparation resource. And you'll see it's also giving you, let me sort of give a wrong answer. Let's see if I can get a deliberately wrong answer to the next one here. The company uses sales. You're implementing a solution that guides users with data entry. Which feature should you use? Yeah, it's definitely not that. So you'll see there that it actually gives you the right answer in the explanation. So that's a very solid learning resource. The other thing that's really important, and I'll put the link to this page in the description below, is the skills measured. So I'm starting here again with 9-10, but as we work through the series, which is sort of back up the list in the rest of this video, we're going to go through MB 210 through 800 as well. Every single one of these exams has this skills measured, and this is the most important thing to do, is to go in here and have a look at it. And you'll see that there are different percentages here. So the core capabilities of the apps, 20 to 25%, customer service, 20 to 25%, whereas marketing is 15 to 20%. You want to make sure that you're allocating your effort appropriately. This one is actually quite evenly spread. Let's take a look at the ERP side of the house here and see if we've got a similar thing. Again, relatively easily spread, but realistically here, the describing of the supply chain management and finance apps are getting up towards 50% of the exam content, whereas commerce, HR, project operations are weighted much lower. So you'd certainly want to be putting your effort in where those skills measured are. Scrolling down here, you'll see each of these then breaks out into more processes. So as you're doing your study, and certainly after you've done your Microsoft Learn Path, you just want to go back and check across all of these. Do you understand what those things are? You'll notice at this foundation level, they're all things like describe. Describe this, describe the use case for that. Whereas as we start to get up, it's so confusing because I have to scroll higher up in the list to get to the smaller numbers. Let's take something like 210, which is the first of the intermediate level exams on the CRM side, and we have a look at the skills measured. Then you'll start to see that you need to be able to configure rather than just describe. So for all of these exams, as you go through, make sure that you have checked those skills taught and followed the Microsoft Learn Path and used any of those other legitimate resources that are available to you. So from here, what I'm going to do is divide the video up into talking first about the CRM exams and then the ERP exams, just because that's the order of the numbers. Jump ahead to where you want to be, or stick with me and watch the whole thing, and then I'll come back at the end with additional resources. So first up here on the CRM side of things, this is the series of exams that start with MB2 something. Now the good news, if you are on CRM or customer engagement side, is the certification pathways are actually really straightforward. The only trick to watch here is that there is overlap with the Power Platform certifications, because these customer engagement apps are actually model-driven Power apps. So all of the skills for the platform underneath actually sit with the Power Platform certification exam. So let me take you through what's what. So we've essentially got four exams here that sit at this intermediate level, this functional consultant associate level, and they go with the four major customer engagement applications. So it's really that quite straightforward. If you want to be a functional consultant in this area, you need at least one of these, obviously. Most functional consultants who work in the customer engagement space would have at least two up their sleeves. Marketing is a little bit of a different specialty, but you'd want to have, say, sales and customer service, or customer service and field service, or so on. Depends on your job and your role, but having more than one of these, I think, is probably a good thing to have that breadth in the platform. So sales up first here, which is the CRM application. This is about basically configuring the sales application, managing and understanding all of those core tables that make up the application, and additional tools and services. There's a lot more detail in the study guide there, but this is essentially the exam you want to do if you are hands-on with dynamic sales or want to be a functional consultant in that area. If you are on the customer service side, MB230 is the equivalent. You'll see you've got a longer description there. Beware, this one actually goes quite deep into the omni-channel capability. It's not just the basic customer service hub case management app. You will need to be across all of the customer service things. Same level though, sits alongside the sales one. And the third one here is the field service application, again going through all of those core components of field service. Now I'm doing these slightly out of order in the numbering. We've gone 210, 230, 240. There is actually a 220, which is marketing. As I said, this one tends to sit a little bit differently. I'm seeing a lot of growth and interest in the marketing application. There's been a lot of investment in this. If you work particularly in the sales side as a functional consultant, it is worth getting across this, at least so that you've got that certification. for my 2 cents worth. So this one is actually taking you through the skills of using the marketing application at that same level. Then there is another exam above that, which is the customer insights exam, which is the data platform specialty. So marketing is its own application. As of the time of recording, which is August 2023, it's still strictly called marketing, but from the 1st of September 2023, that application is going to be called Customer Insights Journeys. Microsoft have announced that the exam won't change. There will still be 2 separate exams, but depending on when you're watching this, it may or may not still be called marketing. In any case, the application that does the journeys, the real-time marketing, MB220, and then the next one here, which is MB260, this is kind of a level above the functional consultant. This one's called specialty, but this is the exam you want to do if you are into the app currently known as Customer Insights, but which will be known as Customer Insights-Data. These are 2 halves of the marketing application. If you're working in this area, I would strongly suggest getting those 2 together as a pair. But also this one has some overlap into people who are coming from that data side of the fence with data analytics and data lakes and so on. I don't come from that world. I'm very much, my background is entirely in this CRM customer engagement world. I've done this certification, so it is absolutely achievable, but it is a level up from the functional consultant certifications on the core Dynamics customer engagement apps. Now, I did mention that there is crossover here with the Power Platform exams. Check out my other video here if you want a full guide to the Power Platform certifications. But if you want to get the expert level certification, if you're working in the customer engagement apps and you want that solution architect highest level expert certification, it actually sits with those Power Apps and Power Platform exams. You will need to do 2 exams to be certified as a solution architect. One of them is the PL200, which is the core sort of Dataverse and platform capabilities, and then the PL600. Or if you prefer, if you're coming from a developer background, you can do PL400. But as I said, check out my other video for all of the details on that. The reason that this sits here is because the underlying platform and the architecting of the underlying platform is actually the same. So you prove your knowledge of those functional apps at that consultant level certification, and then the architecture of the solutions. This has a lot of case studies and ways of thinking about how you would apply all of that into a real customer scenario. Let's take a look at the ERP side of the certifications, which is the finance and operations side. Now, even though at the start I listed out a bunch of things that sit in there, once you get past that core foundational levels, the exams here are all certifying you either in finance or supply chain management. There are no exams listed there specifically for those other applications on project operations, HR, and commerce. So you're really going deep at this intermediate level, either into finance, supply chain, or both. Now, the structure of the finance and ERP operations is, you're going to need more than one exam to get anywhere substantial here. And this one here is core. It's core to all of it. So the MB300 is that core finance and operations intermediate level consultant associate exam. So this is going to give you that grounding in that whole platform and what goes on. And from there, depending on whether you are specializing in the finance application or the supply chain management side of things, you have different pathways. Either way though, if you want a certification as either a functional consultant or an architect, you're going to need this exam. This is like the entry, the gateway to all of the other things. So let's assume you've done that one. Now you get to choose your adventure of where you'd like to go next. So if you are a consultant in the finance space, this is your pathway here. You will do that core exam, and then MB310 is the exam that gives you that consultant level certification in the finance application specifically. You'll notice this is one of the pathways into becoming a solution architect. So there are 3 pathways to becoming a solution architect on the F&O side. One of them is through that core finance and operations, and then the finance certification. The second one is if you're specializing in supply chain. So again, that core MB300, finance and operations. And then this is the associate level, functional consultant level of the supply chain side. This one has two pathways. If you're into this, you've got two places you can go. You've got an expert pathway that levels you up again in supply chain, which I'll come back to, or this can be your other way to get an architect certification. But there is a third option here, of course. If you are coming from the pro dev side of things, then you can do that 300 and MB500, which is a finance and operations app developer. So those three options there, where you've got that core 300 exam, and then you add on the functional consultant exam, either for finance or supply chain, or the developer exam for finance and operations, will get you to that kind of mid-level functional consultant associate certification. And each of those is a pathway into this one here, which is the solution architect. So you are going to need to have done three exams here. You'll have to have done MB300, one of those other ones that I just said, to get that mid-level certification. And then we add the big one on top, which is MB700, and that will qualify you as a solution architect for F&O. Now, the other pathway here, this one isn't called solution architect, but this one sits at the same level. This one is called expert. So if you want to be that sort of top level certified expert in supply chain, again, that takes three exams, the core MB300, which is the core finance and operations piece, the supply chain consultant exam, and then this supply chain expert exam on top. And then your other option in the ERP side of things is the MB800, which is the Business Central exam. Business Central stands alone as its own unique subset and its own exam. One exam, one certification, nice and straightforward there. No other prerequisites from any of the other finance and operations apps. So here we are with the full pathway of the certifications on both sides of the house here. On the left-hand side, the nice and straightforward CRM certifications, fundamentals, four in the middle there for those core applications, a specialty on the customer data platform, which sits at a higher level. And if you want to become an architect, you do need to go back into that Power Platform path. On the ERP side, fundamentals, that MB300 is then just like the pathway to everything else. And then we have got MB310, 500 or 330 as ways to get the functional consultant certification and pathways up into the F&O solution architect and supply chain. And then of course, MB800, which sits nice and straightforwardly there as your Business Central certification standalone. I'm actually thinking, because I come from the CRM side, that MB800 might be something that I'd like to do to test out the learning experience, to put myself back into beginner's shoes. Let me know if you're interested in that, either in a learning path or a sort of a story diary of studying as a beginner. I get a lot of people asking about that kind of thing. What does it take to study? So let me know if you want me to be a guinea pig and we'll see how we go. Now, I did promise you some additional resources in here. So let's take a look at what's available to you. aka.ms/exam demo actually takes you to a spot where you can get a simulated experience of the exam. So if you're not sure, if you've never taken an online exam before, check out my video here that gives you some practical advice of how it works. But also make sure that you do this simulation. It gives you fake kind of hilarious questions, but it will actually take you through what that experience is like inside the exam software, which I find very reassuring if you haven't done it for the first time. And then the other resources that we've got available to us are these practice tests. So pretty much I think all of the exams that I've mentioned here have these practice tests. They do cost money, but they are completely legitimate. They're verified. These are legitimate and useful sources of study. If you do find reassurance of doing those practice tests, then this is something you can do. And there's a whole bunch of them there. I'll put the links in the description to those and you'll find them through in there. Let me know what certification you're taking, whether you think I should put myself up to the challenge of doing MB800 from scratch. Check out my other video here for the full Power Platform certification experience as well. And as always, thanks for watching and good luck with whichever exam you're going forth to take from here.